Now, President Trump also said that he hasn't spoken to Epstein in many years, something sources in both South Florida and New York tell me is true. In fact, two people told me Trump, quote, hated Epstein once he found out what Epstein was about. Listen to this.
Well, I knew him like everybody in Palm Beach knew him. I mean, people in Palm Beach knew him. He was a fixture in Palm Beach. I had a falling out with him a long time ago. I don't think I've spoken to him for 15 years. I wasn't a fan. I was not, yeah, a long time ago, I'd say maybe 15 years. I was not a fan of his, that I can tell you. I was not a fan of his.
And that's where I want to bring in our next guest, longtime Trump friend and advisor and political strategist, Roger Stone. Roger, great to see you.
Great to see you.
Now, Roger, you know the president a long, long time. You knew him personally, you knew him professionally. I've had people in both South Florida and New York City tell me that once Donald Trump got a sense of who Jeff Epstein really was, Trump, quote, hated Epstein. We have a victim's lawyer for the Epstein victims, a guy named Brad Edwards, former Broward County prosecutor, on video saying Donald Trump was one of the few people that helped him in his investigation, his case, a sentiment echoed to me by law enforcement people on the case 10 years ago. What do you say about this? I mean, I believe Donald Trump did not like this guy. He barred him, he banned him from Mar-a-Lago after he found out that Epstein tried to assault the young daughter of a Mar-a-Lago member.
Well, as you know, John, I researched this issue very extensively for my book, The Clintons' War on Women. The longest chapter in this book is on the Epstein case. That's because I spent hours and hours reading through the depositions and court documents of the cases of those women who refused to settle with Epstein. Epstein paid $33 million out in settlements to women, then girls, but Virginia Roberts, very valiantly, now Virginia Roberts Jeffery, refused to settle. I think three people deserve enormous credit for breaking this case back open. One is Julie Brown of the Miami Herald,
yep,
who in a set of crusading, really groundbreaking articles with deep research and a lot of work, got the whole matter back on the agenda.
Right, I agree with you on that. She deserves special mention. She did an outstanding series of reporting on this.
She should get a Pulitzer.
She really should. I agree with you.
Mike Cernovich.
Mike did. Yep.
A lawsuit at a crucial time that was able to unseal certain documents that busted this wide open.
I agree.
And frankly, Conchita Sarnoff, an activist and author who stayed on this case when it went cold and kept on it, wrote a great book on sex trafficking, is an anti-sex trafficking advocate. Those three individuals, I think, deserve enormous credit. Let's get the sequence of events here absolutely correct. The Palm Beach police began this investigation.
Correct.
When a little girl came home with a lunchbox full of cash, and when she told them how she got it and where she got it, they called the police. The police chief, a man named Ryder, who is a straight arrow and a real law enforcement guy, conducted an extensive undercover investigation and got evidence of sex trafficking and multiple assaults on women. And the network that Epstein was using of women as procurers, trawling the bus stations and the train stations.
Roger, and most of the women that he would send out as trawlers, he would send them out with wads of cash. Many of them were prior victims who he groomed and then cultivated into being recruitment agents, really, for his next victims, correct?
That is my understanding.
Yeah.
In any event, the police chief produces his investigation for the state's attorney, a man named Kirshner. And Kirshner, incredibly, charges Epstein with one count of solicitation.
Now, was it Kirshner or McAuliffe? Because McAuliffe was in the office, I believe, when this started, and then Kirshner was appointed, correct?
My understanding was the decision was made under Kirshner.
The decision was. But what I was told by law enforcement in Palm Beach County is that the case initially hit the office when McAuliffe was there. Kirshner came in, was appointed, and then Kirshner then only served a short time and was replaced by the current Palm Beach state attorney. But Kirshner cut the deal, I believe.
That is my understanding. In any event, at that point, Chief Ryder of the Palm Beach Police, a very solid guy, went to the U.S. attorney, then Alexander Acosta, and said, something's not right here. I don't know whether the prosecutor was threatened, whether he was bribed, or whether it was just bad judgment.
Yes.
But something stinks here. We gave you evidence of sex trafficking, extensive sex trafficking, and this was busted down to a parking ticket. As you point out, he was sentenced to 15 months in jail. He only served 13, and he only had to be there from 10 o'clock at night till 6 o'clock in the morning.
Right. He had to sleep in jail. The rest of the time, he was at his Palm Beach mansion trading for his hedge fund, making a fortune.
Not only that, but sex offenders in Florida go to state penitentiaries. They don't go to county jails. So this guy got a slap on the wrist. Now, there is no doubt that the decision at the U.S. Justice Department by Alexander Acosta to not only rubber stamp the state charges, but then to seal the file so that no one would know what happened, had to have been approved by Alberto Gonzalez, George W. Bush's attorney general.
I mean, Roger, I want to go in deep there. I agree with you. I think this could possibly have gone up to the Bush White House. This was a major, major case. There's no way a U.S. attorney cuts this deal unless he goes to the AG, and the AG's not cutting a deal like this that could potentially rock an administration unless the bosses in the White House are okaying it. You've worked around White Houses.
I think you're absolutely right. So we don't know what leverage that Epstein may have had. We have no idea.
But let me throw this at you, because there's a couple of theories out there. Something that Acosta himself alluded to in a letter he sent to the Daily Beast several years back in 2017, 2 years ago. Now, I've had sources say there might be some weight to this, that Jeffrey Epstein was an intelligence community asset. They knew that he was procuring and collecting compromising photos and videos of foreign heads of state, foreign leaders, and that was of such value to the intelligence community that they allowed him to continue to operate and insulated him from prosecution. Look, we saw the government do this in the Whitey Bulger case. We saw the government give cover to Whitey Bulger, a killer, because he was giving them really good info on bad guys. Sammy the Bull Gravano murdered 26 people. Got a slap on the wrist because he gave up John Gotti. So it wouldn't be the first time the government did this. How much weight do you give to the theory that Jeff Epstein was an intelligence asset?
I just have no idea. I'm going to be very anxious to see what Alexander Acosta has to say for himself. What's more troubling to me, John, is the mainstream media effort to erase the connections between the Clintons and Epstein and try to make this a Trump scandal.
Do you know that Google, let's call out Google, Roger, they deserve it. They've scrubbed. I typed in this morning in the last 2 days, Jeff Epstein, Bill Clinton, Lolita Express. You can't find Bill Clinton's name in one of the headlines that comes up on the Google search or the Google News search. They've completely scrubbed Clinton's name and his photos.
And the Wikipedia biography from Epstein has excised the references to Clinton. Here's what we know, indisputably. FAA records show that Bill Clinton was on Epstein's plane 26 times, not one time, as he first said, not four times, as he now said, but 26 times. And on a number of those occasions, he ditched his Secret Service detail. There's indications in many of the depositions that Bill Clinton did visit the what Sean Hannity called Pedo Island,
yeah. They called it Orgy Island, right? His private island off the coast of St. Thomas, right?
We know from documents involved in the non-prosecution agreement that Jeffrey Epstein gave the Clintons $4 million for the Clinton Global Initiative.
And wasn't he one of the founders? Isn't information coming out where the Clinton Global Initiative, the CGI, was actually conceived on Epstein's plane, that he was one of the original founding members of this?
Additionally, we know that the Clinton campaign accepted a contribution from him after he had already been charged in this matter.
Well, then we found out that people like Katie Couric and George Stephanopoulos went to a dinner at his home after he was a charged, convicted, registered pedophile.
The other thing that's extraordinary, of course, is the role of Ghislaine Maxwell, who, by all accounts, was the chief procurer and pimp and major domo of Epstein's operation. She was an honored guest at Hillary Clinton's wedding. At Chelsea Clinton's wedding.
Yes.
So, for the Clintons to deny any relationship here, it is absurd. The statement by Bill Clinton is just riddled with falsehoods. And then to try to tie this unfairly to Donald Trump, whose relationship with Epstein is peripheral at best.
Right.
And it's important to note that in her deposition, Virginia Roberts, one of the victims, says that she met Donald Trump on one occasion with Epstein, that Trump conducted himself as a total gentleman.
Yes,
and she saw no inappropriate activity on his part. This is crucial.
Didn't Ghislaine Maxwell's dad was Robert Maxwell, right? And didn't he die under dubious circumstances as well?
Well, it is alleged that he committed suicide by jumping off the back of the boat.
Right.
He was tightly tied to Israeli intelligence. There's always been suspicion that that was a staged death. Some people who say that would be called conspiracy theorists. I don't know. Now, is Maxwell going to be a witness against Epstein? That's been speculated about.
She's a co-conspirator, in my opinion, though, Roger. This woman should be charged right alongside of him.
But it is amazing that she is an honored guest at Chelsea Clinton's wedding.
Certainly is. Certainly is. Roger Stone, as always, my friend, thanks very much for joining. Great information.
Well, and John, folks can go to stonedefensefund.com to help me in my current ordeal. You've given me a nice contribution. So has Chris Ruddy at Newsmax. I will be forever grateful for your support.
StoneDefenseFund.com. Check out Roger's website. Roger, thanks very much.
You just watched Newsmax TV, America's fastest growing cable news channel. Subscribe to our YouTube channel for breaking news and give us a thumbs up. If you like this video, then share it with your friends. Remember, you can watch Newsmax TV live on YouTube. Newsmax TV, real news for real people.